begin, let's have a quick look at those who'll be fronting the grid. Perez, Verstappen, and Carlos Sainz. Well, that wraps up qualifying, but don't worry, we'll be back tomorrow as we head into the Grand Prix. We're in Belgium once again for today's round of the Formula One World Championship. It's a race that the great Ayrton Senna won 6 times, and in 2019, Charles Leclerc became the first driver to take their maiden win here since Michael Schumacher back in 1992. Spa-Francorchamps today, a circuit that spans 4.35 miles. There are tons of elevation changes along the way too. 19 corners making up this circuit, with 9 of those to the right and the remaining 10 to the left. This track's a great one for fans of pure speed, and the average lap speed comes close to a whopping 145 miles per hour. Off the back of a fantastic qualifying session, it's time to see how our starting grid looks like for today's race. It's Sergio Perez on pole today, and Moore completes the front row. Moving on to the rest of the grid, we have Norris, Russell, Daniel Ricciardo, and Leclerc, Hamilton, Magnussen, Bottas, and Yuki Tsunoda, Verstappen, Gasly, Carlos Sainz, and Albon, Vettel, Joe, Nicholas Latifi, and Lance Stroll, Ocon, and Mick Schumacher. Which of these talented drivers will come out on top today? Anthony Davidson joins me once again in the commentary box. Ant, it's fantastic to have you with us here, but I'm curious, as a man with experience out on the track, how do you stop those pre-race nerves from becoming overwhelming when you're lining up on the grid?
Well, I imagine they'll be starting to feel the adrenaline as they anticipate the rundown into turn one, a bit like preparing to go into battle. The unknown situation will bring nerves, but that's a good thing. It will keep them focused on the moment and on their surroundings as we build towards the start of the Grand Prix.
Launch map is good, but we need to learn the gears, so go into each one when you can. We're going to need some work on the brakes, so put some energy into them and warm the tyres as well, please. Superb park. In there, mate. Let's make sure we get the edge on the surrounding drivers as the lights go out. Okay, so that's the rest of the grid forming up now. Be patient and watch for those lights. Okay, we think the underbody's incurred some slight damage, but nothing too serious at the moment, just be careful. Okay, watch your pace, we're in full. We'll be right back.
just got to trust me. I'm taking you to battle, yeah?
There, she's done it! You've done it! Well done! Great stuff, mate! Great stuff!
A difficult race then on one of the all-time classic circuits, but they persevered to take the win here today. Tell me, Ant, how do you think they were able to deliver such an incredible result today?
I think it was clear what the main contributing factor out on track was: speed. I know it sounds like an awfully reductive statement, but fast cars win races, and we saw that today with our winner.
Looks like they're on their way out onto the podium now, and what a result this is, and a popular one with the crowd as well. Great stuff to see the Alfa Romeo team on top here today. Increases their championship lead. Well, after an incredible day of racing, who was your driver of the day, Ant?
Carlos Sainz would be my first choice for this race. He had excellent race stamina, giving him the opportunity to charge through the ranks.
Let's move on to the constructors. McLaren continue to increase their gap at the top. Well, that was certainly an exciting weekend of Formula One. Be sure to join us for more exciting Formula One action very soon.
We've got an issue we'd like your input on.
Thanks for handling that.